Welcome to Antenna and Wave Propagation Lecture Series. I, Professor Hitesh Dholakia, is going to explain you co-polarization and cross-polarization in this session. So to understand co-polarization and cross-polarization, these are my session outlines, where in this session, first I'll discuss basics regarding polarization. After that, I'll explain comparison of co-polarization and cross-polarization. After that, we will see different parameters which is there regarding co-polarization and cross-polarization. So based on these outlines, this session is there. So let us begin this session with first agenda, that is basics of polarization. Now first of all, we should understand what is the meaning of polarization. In electromagnetic waves, when electromagnetic waves travels in the space, orientation of electric field defines polarization. So in short, we can say polarization is orientation of electric field. So polarization explains you what is the orientation of electric field in propagation of EM wave. By tracing electric field vector, we can identify which type of polarization is there. So I'll explain you different types of polarization so that you will get to know like how we can trace electric field vector. So let us see the different cases which is there with polarization by classifications. So classifications is been done based on orientation of electric field with respect to position. So we'll see that with respect to different position, and based on that, first category is linear polarization, second is circular polarization, and third is elliptical polarization. So in linear polarization, orientation of electric field stays linear. So over here you can see in diagram, electromagnetic waves is propagating in this direction, you can see. And in this propagation, this is what the direction which is there with electric field by blue color one can see. And by red color, magnetic field propagation is happening. So here you will be observing when this EM wave is propagating, electric field stays vertical. So here electric field orientation is vertical. So we can say this is a category of linear polarization. And in linear polarization, we can say this is vertical polarization. And if this electric field stays horizontally throughout the propagation, then one can say this is linear polarization with horizontal orientation. So that is horizontal linear polarization. Now, if you see this second case where propagation is happening, and here it is quite difficult to understand orientation of magnetic field as if I plot it. So I have only plotted electric field, where you can observe electric field orientation is revolving in circular pattern and it forms helical shape, you can see. So during propagation, orientation is revolving in circular pattern. So you can observe in counterclockwise direction, this orientation is happening and it is propagating in this direction. So this is a case of circular polarization. Now, what is the difference in between circular polarization and elliptical polarization? So that even I will explain you by a diagram. So as earlier I have discussed linear polarization. So in linear polarization, here right now orientation of electric field, that you can say that stays vertical. For positive up cycle, it is there in this direction, you can see, and for negative up cycle, it stays in this direction and it is not changing with respect to orientation. So this is linear polarization, right? Now when we talk about circular polarization, so here in circular polarization, you can see electric field is revolving with respect to time. So that is what the case which I have explained over here even. But here by animation, again, you can see how it happens with respect to time. This electric field will revolve, right? So as it propagates like this, that will get revolved. And if you observe magnitude of electric field during that revolution, you will be finding it is having magnitude with radius r, which is having constant radius. So that is a case of circular polarization. And in circular polarization, there could be two different cases. If orientation of electric field is revolving in clockwise direction, right, then one can say that is left hand circular polarization. And if orientation of electric field revolves in counterclockwise direction, then one can say that is right hand circular polarization. So that is how we can define circular polarization. Now, if you observe elliptical polarization, then same thing will happen as it happens in case of circular polarization. So here first you just see it by animation, so it will be a bit clear, like see how things are happening. Here even that is revolving, right? And magnitude that is revolving with respect to time as it is happening in circular over here. But if you observe lateral dimension and longitudinal dimension, then there is a difference, right? So here radius is not constant, and as we know, elliptical shape is having different dimensions with respect to longitudinal direction and with respect to lateral dimension. So here this magnitude is less compared to this magnitude, which forms elliptical shape. So we can say this is elliptical polarization. So that is a category of circular polarization only, but here magnitude is not constant with respect to radius as it forms circular shape only, but magnitude is different, which is a case of elliptical polarization. So this is how different classification has been there. Now basic agenda of this session is to understand what is cross polarization and what is co-polarization. So based on this polarization only we can understand it. So I have made initial basics of this. Now let us try to understand what is co-polarization and what is cross polarization. Now we will discuss that with respect to different parameters, and if you see that by definition, then one can understand this. Like, see, co-polarization, that is a desired polarization. Like, see, when we design any instrument, at that time we identify intended parameters. So intended means the parameters which is required in actual design. So that is what desired parameters. So here in polarization, even desired polarization is co-polarization, and orthogonal to desired, that is cross polarization. Like if I say I'm sending signal with vertical polarization, then perpendicular to vertical is what? Orthogonal to vertical, and that is what? Cross polarization. So by having measurement of cross polarization, we can identify how much amount of noise is there in signal. So basic, as per basic definition, one can say desired polarization is copolarization, and orthogonal to desired means undesired polarization is cross polarization. If you see direction, then desired direction is copolarization direction, and orthogonal to desired means undesired direction is cross polarization. If you see signal, then signal power will be always there in copolarization, which defines strength of the signal, and undesired direction polarization is cross polarization, which defines strength of noise. Let us try to understand that by one example, so it will be more clear. If I send a signal with vertically polarized signal, then copolarization is there in vertical polarization. And if we send signal with vertically polarized signal, then cross polarization will be there with horizontal polarization, means orthogonal to it. Now, if you want one more example, then I can say if I send right hand circular polarization with copolarization, then left hand circular polarization will be cross polarization. See, that is how case is there. So I hope that based on this understanding, you will be able to identify what is required in sending signal of EM wave, and this will be helpful to you in antenna and wave propagation understanding. So based on that, so many questions can be resolved. Thank you so much for watching this video. Please do give your valuable suggestions. The reason is your suggestions are giving motivation to me, and in future, based on your request, I'll place videos which will be helpful to students, those who are learning from my channel. Thank you so much for watching this video.